and there was this big Georgian house, and I found out later that it had been empty for 27 years, but people got in there and they squatted there, and they built it up, and it was incredible. And what they used to do there, and they still do, is that they would do courses starting from the weekend up until 6 months. And the knowledge that they gave was about self-knowledge, not about religion, no, but about being yourself. So I went up there and I was volunteering and I was just working around, and for the first couple of months nobody said anything to me, you know. They used to do meditation there, and I checked it out. I'd never done anything like that in my life. Went into meditation in the morning. Then one day the principal said to me, "Andy, into the office." And I thought I was going to be getting kicked out, right? He says, "Andy, would you like to do a 6-month course here at Chisholm House?" I said, "I don't know. What's it all about?" He says, "It's about you. It's about who you really are. You have an opportunity to delve into what you are." And he also said, "Just don't, because once you start it, it's a retreat. Once you start it, you're in." And I thought, well, fuck, man, I've got the roof. I'll do it. I'll do it. And it was such a fucking hard regime, man. You woke up in the morning at 6 o'clock, showered, stuff like that, meditation. The four pillars to the place were meditation, study, work, and spiritual practice. And everything, once you start that course, is fucking geared to that. There were 6 of us on this course. And when I first started, for the first month, we were reading kind of Sufi, if anybody's familiar with Ibn Arabi, Jalaluddin Rumi. And you just get right into it. And what they did is that you sat around the table and you had the text in front of you and you read the text, and then it was open for discussion. And then you just went into this fucking journey right in. It's incredible. Anyway, it's so huge. Anyway, I couldn't comprehend it. I really couldn't. I couldn't wrap my head around it. I was there for a month, and you know, it didn't make any sense. And then one day, he brought out a little book called Know Thyself by Ibn Arabi. And I was sitting there, and everybody's just talking about it, not discussing everything like that. And I'm thinking, this is, I can't do it. And it was just like, all of a sudden, it was like a fucking Star Wars movie. You know, like all these intergalactic things. Just went whoosh, right in front of my eyes. Like, boom! And everything fucking clear. I couldn't believe it. And I looked around and everybody's talking and stuff like that. And I slapped my hand on the table and I was like, fuck man, I got it. And the lad who was in charge with all said, it's time for a break. And I went outside for a cigarette. I want to share this with you all because I don't know, guys. I went outside for a cigarette and I was in the back of the building and it was shade. I'm a smoker. And I could see the sunlight coming from the side of the building. So I went out to the side of the building, smoking my cigarette. And as I walked through this, it was just like strobes of light from a tree. I came around to the front of the house and I stood there and I gazed. And the sun and the sky, grass, the trees, it was everything, and it was in with me. You may think this sounds corny, I could hear a fucking bee fly by, and it came, and as that bee went by, it was almost like he looked at me, and he winked. And he says, yeah, man. And I stood there. I thought I was tripping, man. And I just had this feeling of, yeah, it's so hard to explain. People have tried to explain this experience. They say, I can't explain it, but then they go down and write it with 1,000 words and stuff like that. I looked to the sky and I saw a crow going by. And as I saw the crow, it was like, it went to slow motion. Everything went right down into slow motion. And as I looked onto the horizon, I had this feeling that something was going to happen. And when I looked, it was like this invisible wave came down. I came, just come down. And I could feel it. I could feel it. I could feel it. I could feel it. Right through me. It was the fucking biggest orgasm I had in my life. And I was shaking. It's like, what is this? So I went back, talked to a couple of people in there. Then about a few hours later, the principal came in to one of our classes. And he sat opposite of me. And he's just looking at us. And after the class was finished, we sat there and we just fucking laughed our heads off. And he's like, yeah, man, this is it. This is it, right, man? Got it. This is it, man. Fucking life. And then he said, hold on to your seatbelt. Fucking fasten it because this is going to get more of it. I don't know what I'm saying, guys. All I'm saying is when you open your hearts up, when you really, really get into your heart and let it open and be receptive.